Hey, this is Frank. We're looking at my dash, my virtual dash. It is running on Torque Pro on Android, and this is inside my 2G RFE swapped SW20 MR2 Mark II. So I have a number of dials and indicators on the main dash, starting from the top left and growing clockwise. We have throttle position, which at idle is normally 16. The speed, the RPM, the normal RPM speed of this engine is about 660, 650. This is with the AC on right now. I'm going to turn off the AC. It goes up, stabilizes after a minute at about 800. So there is no AC, you know, whatever thing. Continuing with the AC back on, I got the coolant temperature. I've got the intake air temperature. This is coming off of the MAF sensor. And with the car parked, this tends to heat soak a little bit, or to heat up in the engine compartment. This is not really a heat soak. It's just getting hotter and hotter in there because we're not moving right now. Okay, bottom right hand corner is the load as returned by OBD2. This is the absolute load. This corresponds approximately to the engine filling ratio or volumetric efficiency, okay, without getting into a lot of technical detail. Then continuing counterclockwise, continuing clockwise, we have the timing advance at idle. It's in this range, that's normal. Commanded AFR, we're in closed loop. The ECU is commanding stoichiometric, and then you can see that it's doing the best it can with O2 feedback to hit that target. Okay, pretty close. Now, let's flip to the next screen where we look at this more closely. Here we have the short-term and long-term fuel trims. Okay, and this is useful for diagnosing issues. It's a real-time chart being returned. I am running with an eBay 3-inch intake with a standard MAF sensor and nothing special done to anything. There is no modification of the MAF calibration, nothing. It's all just plugged in and you're seeing it run as is. So here we have, on the bottom, I have little dials for the long-term and short-term trims on each cylinder, and on the top, not each cylinder, each bank, and on the top I have the real-time chart of the short-term. Now this is really useful in diagnosing issues, okay, because if you see your thing going out of whack, then you take a look at this quickly, and let's see how it changes if I rev it up a little. Okay, it moves around a little bit, so you know the engine does, the ECU does whatever it needs to. And these long-term fuel trims are modified and stored over time. The short-term trims are instantaneous. Okay, so this is what I wanted to show today. Normal running 2G RFE. And with nothing special. All right, and I want to mention my thanks and acknowledgement to Marc Labranche, aka Gookie, at Frankenstein Motor Works for de-immobilizing this ECU. And also shout out to Doug Copeland at MR220V. Wire gap for the harness. Thanks for watching.